Last thing to get out, you get this side off, the ground off first, ground this off a little bit, and then it'll be completely taken apart. So I'm just going to take the grinder, grind these down, and then I'll show you guys just how bad this is. Alright, so we got it all shaved off here, so what I'm going to do is just take this and just hammer it. You guys get the idea. Alright guys, wasn't recording, but I hit one hard time and ouch, that's sharp. Hey, we got this off now. Hang on. Hey, we got it off. So, let me show you guys just what we got going. Alright, so, we got it all taken apart. We have this, and it's, you can tell it's pretty bad in there. This is, you know, dirty. It's all, they all have some, these all have pretty significant rust on them. And what we're going to do is we're just going to take a bucket, fill it with some soapy water, just clean these off, because it's like, and it's like, yeah, it's pretty dirty in there. So I'm going to fill up a bucket with some Dawn's dish soap and coarse water. We're going to put these in here, just going to scrub, because that way when we put them in the sandblaster, we don't have all of that gunk stuff that's, it's just mostly in here, but from all that lubricant that my dad sprayed onto these to get, because this was seized before we, before I got it. And that way, we're just gonna have everything nice and ready for the sandblaster. Alright, so this is the container that we're gonna be using. And we're just going to pour some Dawn's dish soap into it so we can get them all nice and clean. Let's see how dirty the water gets. Brush. Actually cleaning out pretty nice. Still has some pretty decent sized chunks in there. I'm gonna do this and I'll show you guys the final result after the cleaning of in the water, and then we are going to sandblast them. Alright guys, we got it all taken, it all washed up. So just letting it dry now. everything for it. This connects to this. This is what this is for. And I'm gonna keep, these, because these, we're gonna get something that'll match this, and we're gonna be able to just put them through here and then hammer them down so they keep this stuff in place. But once it's fully dried off, then I'm gonna put it in the sand blaster, and that is gonna be what really gets all of this rust off. But we are of course going to need to do a little bit of sanding, because there's gonna be a lot of pitting in it from the rust just eating away at it since it's been sitting in a gutter. Yeah, that's crazy. There was another one of these. My dad has the other one at his work, but yeah, these came out of this, and the other one came out of the gutter. And yeah, these are pretty rusted. So I'm gonna take a quick break, let these dry off. Then we're gonna put them in sandblaster, just get it all sandblasted, nice and just make it all nice and clean. And then we'll go over it with some sandpaper to get it all nice and just flat, so there isn't any like pitting in it where like the rust ate away at and it's no longer like leveled. It's got all this in it. That's what we're gonna need to fix. But anyway, I'm gonna take a quick break, and the next scene is just gonna be us sandblasting it. So hopefully it'll clean up good. I think it will. It should be fine. Anyway, take a quick break, come back to it, and hopefully it'll be dried off by then. Alright guys, so this is what everything currently looks like. It's all pretty rusty, and we're going to put it in the sandblaster. Just need to get a good shot of what everything looks like first. And of course, we're not going to be sandblasting this or this.
lights off for a second.
Well, our misfortune deal here is that I kind of misplaced this little, it's kind of a roll pin that goes in through there. I am going to attempt to make that with this steel rod. You can look at the new one. Have the pin that's already in there and smashed. They don't use a roll pin. I'm gonna improvise and we'll see how this goes. Hopefully we can get it right. We'll see. Put some earmuffs on and we're gonna let it roll. See how far it came here.
Oh, that's close.
I think I got a little bit longer to go.
And we did do this already with this piece, but we cut it too short, so we're doing it again.
Yeah, we'll get her this time. sometimes you gotta do with what you got. We don't have a lathe, so we kind of improvise with a drill motor and a 40 grit flap wheel for a 4-inch wheel grinder. It's doing the trick so far, so we'll go a little bit more. Imagine that's going to be a lot closer. I just started it. Just a tiny, tiny bit more. This one will fit. That looks like a nice fit. See if this one will fit. That one. You don't want it too loose, otherwise it won't fit in there nice. Let me see, Weston. So that'll work for this one. I think. This time I won't cut her short, I'll cut it long, and we'll have that pin ready for you here in a minute. Now we're going to assemble our little piece we got here into the other end of this vise grip. Put the unlocker, hopefully in there nice. A little sandpaper, emery cloth here, and gotta do some finishing touches, taking some of these down a little bit, but overall seems to function pretty goddamn good. a little bit more painting on it.
All right, we're gonna give it the extra coat of paint. Looks good. Alright. Appears that this is all done. Just need to let it dry and it'll be all done.